Dear learners of Standard 8, welcome back to my business geography class. Hope that you all are safe and sound at home by the mercy of Almighty Allah. Previous day, I had discussed with you about the population policy of Bangladesh and the government initiatives to control the population of Bangladesh. Today, I am going to discuss about the non-government initiatives and how we can convert the population into human resource. As we know, we have enough or huge human, that means population in our country. So, let's start the class. First, we will know about the NGO, non-governmental organization. It can be helpful for the development of the society as well as the country. Organizations which are independent of government involvement are known as non-governmental organizations or non-government organizations. NGOs are a subgroup of organizations founded by citizen country people, which include club and associations that provide service to their members and others. NGOs are usually non-profit organizations, and many of them are active in humanitarianism or the social sciences. That is, the most of the cases, NGOs are usually non-profitable organizations, and NGOs helps the country people in all respects of their need, and which always do the work for the development of the society. So, non-government development organizations can be regional, national and international levels. They are playing an important role in the task of controlling population in Bangladesh. And they started their work in our country by assisting the people in rehabilitation task after our liberation war. So, after our liberation war in the year 1971 and after this year, they also helping besides the government initiatives to control the population of our country. And one of the major fields of work of the NGOs is population control and family planning programs. So, to control the population, we must have to give a focus on the family planning programs. These organizations working in Bangladesh perform many activities to control our population. So, their activities have been discussed one by one. What type of activities they are doing in our country? First, community-based family planning program. Then, implementation of making a planned family of two children, registrants of child marriage, training program, awareness activities, encouragement program of religious leaders. They are doing different types of works in our country. So, one by one, from community-based family planning, CBFP, community-based family planning. This family planning brings family planning information and methods to women and men where they live, rather than requiring them to visit health facilities. One of the main objectives of community-based family planning programs is to increase access to and choice of contraceptive methods, that is the different types of medicine to control the population in underserved areas. Under this program, service is also given for the health and mother and child, providing vaccination, injection and nutritional education. So, dear learners, we can say this community-based family planning program, under this program, people living in villages and towns are given advice and education to keep family small. And they are also encouraged to accept these family planning methods, how to control the population small, or how to make a small children family. Then a two child policy is given, that is this is the implementation of making a planned family of two children. A two child policy is the government imposed limit of two children allowed per capita, per family, or the payment of government subsidies only to the first two children. And you know, by this time the slogan of Bangladesh on population is, be it son or daughter, two children are sufficient. So, our two-child policy has previously been used in several countries, including Iran, Singapore and Vietnam, in British Hong Kong in the year 1970s. Citizens were also highly encouraged to have two children as a limit, and it was used as part of the region's family planning strategies. Since 2016, it has been re-implemented in China, replacing the country's previous one-child policy. So China also, to control the population, China given the policy, one-child policy, for controlling the children of their population of their country. So Bangladesh government also has finalized the national policy of making two children family, be it son or daughter, two children is enough. And non-government organizations are working to achieve this goal, and they are also working to encourage people to accept family planning method. Number C, resistance of child marriage. Child marriage refers to any formal marriage or informal union between a child under the age of 18 and an adult or another child. And by this time you have learned that for marriage, the age of the female person must be 18 and male 21. So while the prevalence of child marriage has decreased worldwide from 1 in 4 girls married a decade ago to approximately 1 in 5 today, in practice remains widespread. So according to this information about from the this information comes from the UNICEF. So these non-government organizations are also playing a significant role to encourage people to register the child marriage. If we can register the child marriage, we can control the population of our country. Then number D, the specialist, that is training program. We have to formulate different types of training for programs. The specialist of non-government organizations are also training the people on the health care of the mother and the child, vaccination and the family planning method. And human reproduction planning is the practice of internationally controlling the rate of growth of a human population. Historically, human population planning has been implemented with the goal of increasing the rate of human population growth. So human reproduction planning is the practice of intentionally controlling the rate of growth of human population. If we can practice we will make our small family and we will make the happy family, we can provide the basic demands of our children, so we can intentionally control our family quite nicely. Then number E, awareness activities. The non-government organizations make and use various items for people causes to address population problem. For example, they are making different types of magazines of family planning, poster, calendar, chart, newsletter, documentary films. These documentary films represents the disadvantages of the large family and merits of the small family are made and used to this effect. And lastly, encouragement programs of religious leader. Encouragement programs of the religious leader of our country. So the influence of the religious leaders is immense in our society. So they can also encourage the people of the villages or remote area to control the population of our country. The non-government organizations arrange workshop for the religious leaders and encourage them about this matter, and the religious leaders can also play a role to reduce the population of our country. Then human resource, the relation between population and the human resource. Human resource, first we will know the population of Bangladesh is very large if we compare it to the area of land and the population of other countries of the world. So moreover, as the population of our country is large, so our humans must be converted into human resource. So human resources is the set of people who make the workforce or labor force of an organization, business or corporate sector, industry or the economy. And human resource is one of the important assets of an organization. So if this large population can be converted to the proper resources, so we can make the human resource. So our growth rate of population is also very high, though the present growth rate is less than that of previous one. So this has been possibly only owing to family planning programs and increasing consciousness of the people. So by adopting the family planning program and increasing the awareness of the people, we can control the population of the country. On the other side, the death rate of infant and mother has recently come down for the improvement of the Medicare management also. So our countries, the population can easily be converted into human resources by providing proper facilities for education, training and employment opportunities for the uneducated and unemployed persons. So if we can provide the proper education and if we can execute the proper training in that means the youth, towards the youth, and if we can solve the unemployment problem of our country, we can control the population, especially for the youths of the country. By this way, the country will go first towards economic development. So only human resource can take a great role or can take a part for the economic development of a country. A huge population of a country becomes a great problem for her if its resources is limited. Again, the population can be turned into human resource by adopting proper planning. So many countries of the world have already turned their large population into human resources. So we can cite the example of China in this regard. Our neighboring countries, India and Sri Lanka, have also shown success in turning population into human resource. In this case, India has advanced much in the field of information technology. 23% of the information technology sector of a developed country like USA depends on skilled manpower of India. So follow, it's a great achievement for India. Say developed country like USA depends on skilled manpower of India, and India is providing this 23% of the information technology so towards the developed country. In the last few years, the present government has invested of our country, the present government of our country has invested a lot in IT sector for developing the digital Bangladesh. And government has taken a massive program to turn our youth power into resource. So to control our country's population, we must have to turn the human, this large population into human resource. Now we will know about the vision of the digital Bangladesh. So what is the vision of digital Bangladesh? This includes all classes of people and does not discriminate people in terms of technology. The government further emphasized on the four elements of digital Bangladesh vision, which are human resource development, people involvement, civil services and use of information technology in business. So if we can give this focus, or if we can do the large work to do this type of work, or to emphasize this work, so we can ultimately get the digital Bangladesh. So how can which technology or techniques or strategy adopted to turn the population into human resource? To expand job-oriented education and build knowledgeable society. So to build up a knowledgeable society, we must have to give more focus of the job-oriented education. To increase the skill and expand training-oriented program, then to expand technology and technical education, to expand women education, to expand health and nutrition program, to adopt education and training program according to production-based sectors, cottage industry, garments industry, especially to expand the agriculture-based education and training, to modernize agriculture for employment opportunities, to improve information and communication sector, to expand small and cottage industries, to send a large number of meritorious students to the developed and technology-based countries of the world by arranging more scholarships through government and non-government initiatives. So if we can send this large number of meritorious students to the developed country, from there they will get enough knowledge and that can be executed in our country. So dear learners, you know, in Bangladesh the gradual development of industry has brought about great changes of women's lives and their dignity. So if we can focus on the women education, we can get a knowledgeable society also, and we can modernize the agriculture agricultural tools must be modern, because our country is depends on largely depends on agriculture, we know. But in our country, these based in our agricultural based economy, the area of agricultural land is gradually decreasing. So in agriculture, high yielding seed, fertilizer, irrigation facilities and modern cultivation methods are being applied. So we can get, or we can turn our human resource for overpopulation into human resources. So dear learners, today up to this. Thank you all. Stay safe and blessed at your home.